trip down the hill. And my mother was just so choked up. We only had a minute before we went up the hill, and the last thing I heard when she already thought I hung up was just like, I'm so happy. So there he was, us. My brother, who lives in a wheelchair in Germany, and his wife, wonderful wife, taking care of him, and their two children that I'm all going to see in August when I go there, and we'll probably do some kind of a celebration there. And then the many people that, you know, the many people that aren't here today, but that I so love. I had such a hard time to think. We thought about who to invite, and I thought, who would we not invite? Like, I could literally have the whole world here. And feeling how yesterday so much of our circle was around the work. And the truth is that this work, this life, this love, it's all intertwined. And so the many people that have known us through the work, that has loved us, that have helped us hold the ceremony, I want to call all of them in. Everyone really who holds love, who is having the guts to open to it, to feel it, and then to also give it. I want to call all of them in.
And then the specific community, Will and Wynn and Juju.
Could be here.
So, a wedding is an opportunity for the community to witness the bonds of love. And so our community is together, but our community is bigger than just the people. This is our community. It's the land from which we come from. It's the land of which we are. And so we want to invite the four shields to come in to the ceremony. And so those who are representing the shields.
Stephen might say, he's, what took you so long? To do it this way, organically. It's been shaped and woven and strengthened by crisis, by really being able to listen to each other's needs and to their own. Again and again, I've watched you. As hard as it's been sometimes, how do we find the we? And sometimes it was really fragile. And sometimes it was like a celebration. Awe. And through that way in which what happened in you and what you are, the way it shaped your relationship, and as fragile as it is at times, there's a sense of how strong the bedrock is. It's just the image of the buildings that are built to withstand earthquakes that somehow move the foundation in order to accommodate. That's what you've done. I've watched it again and again. So clearly they have been, you have been witnessed by the mountains and by each other. And you've made very special commitments to each other and to each other's family. And now it's time to have it witnessed by your people. say that because there's something, even as they say, well, we don't really need to do this, they know the power of ceremony. And they also, this, what I hear again and again, is that this witnessing is a commitment to you, to their people, to their community. It's saying in front of all of you, we stand as a couple together here. Something that shifts, or maybe is today. I don't know what it's going to
So all these times I've been thinking about what I'm going to say to you up here, and every time I've tried, the words that have come to me is, there's nothing new I can tell you today, because I feel like I've said it all to you, but that what I'm going to say today is new, and yet you may have heard it, and you're going to hear it new, and I'm going to say it differently, because we are on this side now, and in this new threshold. And we are heard not just by the mountains who've heard it all before, but also by the community. And what I want to say to you is that
they deserve each other, I guess. So Petra, do you take Joseph to be your lawful husband? Great joy.
Nothing is fixed forever and forever and forever. It is not fixed. The earth is always shifting. The light is always changing. The sea does not cease to grind down rock. Generations do not cease to be born, and we are responsible to them because we are the only witnesses they have. The sea rises. The light fails. Lovers cling to each other. And children cling to us. The moment we cease to hold each other, the sea engulfs us and the light goes out. It's from James Baldwin.
And I love that food.
Yes.
Yes.
People are coming up and saying, boy, how beautiful your place looks. I'm saying, thank you. There's nothing here, practically nothing here, but logs us. So what an incredible thing, the community come together and bring flags and tablecloths and tables and flowers and food. And so thank you for making our home beautiful. Thank you for making this day beautiful. Mm.
I couldn't imagine this any more beautiful. This is a dream come true, and it's more beautiful than anything I could have dreamt of.
It's going to be more beautiful when we get
dancing. Yeah, indeed.
Yeah.